once again to Commissioner Nick Bockwinkel for coming back out here and keeping us abreast of what's going on. And hopefully within this program, we will hear what the committee has to say about Flair's want to come back into the match for Super Brawl in the Cage Sunday, February 20th.
I don't know why they just didn't make me the commissioner. You don't need a board of directors. You don't need a championship committee. Just run it by me. I can handle it.
I bet you can. Okay, suppose you are the commissioner. Flair calls you like he did earlier and says, hey, I saw what happened. I went back in the match with Vader. You're the commissioner. What's your decision?
First of all, I see if there's any gratuities headed my way. Well, you got to look at it that way, Tony.
No, you don't.
Yeah, you do. And if there's nothing, then I say, okay, sign a release. We're not responsible for your carcass. You want to get in there, go ahead. But you ought to leave something for me in case something happens.
Bobby, come on. Here we go. Thunder and lightning. We hopefully will hear, as you heard Nick Bockwinkel say, a little bit later on in this program, a decision, possibly a decision from the WCW Board of Directors or the WCW Championship Committee, actually, and Commissioner Nick Bockwinkel about Flair. Is he back in the match for Super Brawl? Stay with us. We'll find out later on, hopefully, and also Sting and Lord Steven Regal. But now two youngsters, Thunder and Lightning. Thunder in the ring. They'll be going into Super Brawl against another rough and rugged team, Harlem Heat, Bobby the Brain.
Well, I got to go with Harlem Heat. They're just a lot bigger. Now, these guys aren't midgets. These are big, big men. But Harlem Heat is just awesome. And the way they've been coming on lately here in WCW, they're championship material.
Kicking out now.
You know how tough they are?
How tough?
They used to walk through Central Park in New York with $20 bills hanging out of their pockets. And when they got back to where they started, they had 50s.
Into the midsection. And a knee left to the jaw. One, two, a two count. Well, that's pretty tough, right?
I'd say.
Arm drag takedown, Ricky Tango. Two fine athletes, Thunder and Lightning. Two youngsters, though. I mean, they are real, real young. Probably the youngest tag team in WCW at this time.
Well, they're not 6 and 7 years old.
Well, no.
That's real young.
Vertigo suplex and a cover. There's Bill Payne breaking that one up. And Nick Patrick sends both men back. Ricky Tango makes the tag. Whoa, there's a classic leg trip for you. And a tag, and here comes Thunder back in. Into the midsection. Big forearm shot. Sending Payne back to the ropes. Sending Payne down to the other side. The elbow. Thunder and Lightning awaiting Super Brawl.
Because him and Edgar's no relation to Max Payne, is he?
No.
Or Carol Payne?
No. Into the ropes, a pickup and a power slam.
I believe the beginning of the end is close for Mr. Payne.
Up on top.
Oh! I like that.
Big clone. One, two, three.
It wasn't the clothesline that got him. It was a short stop.
Thunder and Lightning come up with a big win here on WCW Saturday Nights. On a night we'll never forget as we still await the decision or sort of rendering from WCW Commissioner Nick Bockwinkel on the Flair Vader match, which right now still has been postponed from Super Brawl. Bobby Enid.
Well, knowing the commission like I do, he's going to be busy. Thunder and Lightning here, I forget which one is which. Suplexes is Hammond Eggers, guy dressed like a zebra. Now watch this sudden stop. Boom! Can you imagine that happening on the highway?
Wow.
It's over.
All right, Thunder and Lightning, your winners as we go down to ringside with me, Gene Okerlund, here on WCW Saturday Night.
I like to get Okerlund like that.
All right, you got to be impressed with Thunder and Lightning here.